Victory over Jericho, Joshua 5:13 through 6:24. Joshua, the new leader of the Israelites, camped with God's people outside the land God had promised to them. Joshua knew there were strong people living in the land, but he was ready to lead the Israelite army against them. Jericho was the first city the Israelites would attack. Joshua sent two spies to check out the city's army and defenses. The spies entered Jericho and went to Rahab's house. Jericho's king heard that the spies were at Rahab's house. His men came looking for them. Rahab hid the spies under some flax on her roof and told the king's men that the spies had left the city. When the king's men were gone, Rahab went back up to the roof. Rahab told the spies that she knew their God was the true God. She asked the spies to save her and her family from the Israelites' attack. The spies told her to stay in her house during the attack, and she would live. Rahab let the spies down from her window by a red cord. As the spies left, they told Rahab to put that red cord in the window when the attack began. After hiding for 3 days, the spies returned to Joshua with good news. They reported that the people of Jericho had heard the Israelites were coming and were afraid of what God might do to them. Joshua was glad to hear the people of Jericho were frightened. God told Joshua it was time to cross over the Jordan River and enter the land. The priests went first and carried the Ark of the Covenant. As soon as their feet touched the water, God parted the water to show the Israelites that just as he had been with Moses, he also was with them. While the priests stood in the middle of the river, the people walked by them on dry ground. Joshua set up 12 stones in the middle of the river as a reminder that God had parted the river for the Israelites. Each of the 12 tribes also took a stone from the river and piled them in their camp as a reminder of what God did for them. As soon as all the people had passed through the riverbed, the priests carried out the ark. God then caused the waters to flow again. The Israelites camped near Jericho and waited for God's instructions. As Joshua walked near the city, a stranger with a drawn sword appeared. Joshua was scared. "Are you for us or our enemies?" he asked. "I am the commander of the army of the Lord," the stranger answered. Joshua fell on his face and worshiped the Lord. The Lord told Joshua to take off his sandals, for he was standing on holy ground. Then the Lord told Joshua his battle plan for defeating Jericho. This was the plan he gave Joshua. March around the city one time every day for 6 days in this order. Put part of the army in the front, followed by 7 priests blowing trumpets and 4 priests carrying the Ark of the Covenant. Another part of the army will go last. On the 7th day, march around the city 7 times while the priests blow their trumpets. When you hear a long blast on the trumpets, all the people will shout and the walls will fall down. You will walk right into the city and take it. The army and priests marched around the city of Jericho once a day for 6 days, just as God instructed. The priests blew their trumpets, but no one else made a sound. The rest of the people of Israel quietly watched without saying a word. The people of Jericho had no idea what Israel was doing. They were nervous and scared about being attacked. None of them dared leave the security of their city. On the 7th day, the Israelites marched around the city 7 times. On the 7th time around the city, the priests gave a long blast on their trumpets. Joshua commanded, "Shout, for the Lord has given you this city." More than 2 million Israelites shouted with a great noise, and the Lord knocked down Jericho's walls with a thundering crash. The Israelites ran into the city and destroyed every living thing, except for one family. Joshua had told the 2 spies to go to Rahab's house, the only part of the city still standing, and bring out her family. Rahab's family was safe, just as the spies had promised. The Israelites took gold, silver, and other valuables from the city and put them in the Lord's treasury. They burned the remains of the city. News of the victory spread throughout the promised land. God had showed his mighty power. Rahab put her faith in God and lived with the Israelites. Eventually, she married a man named Salmon and became the great-great-grandmother of King David. God promised David that one of his descendants would be the Messiah. Years later, Jesus was born as a fulfillment of God's promise. Jesus, God's perfect Son, died on the cross for our sins. If we put our faith in Him, He will save us from the punishment of our sins.